Betty's Kitchen. Today for lunch we're making a grilled ham and cheese sandwich with herb mayonnaise. And I have a previous upload of herb mayonnaise to let you know how to make that. If you don't want to use that, just use regular mayonnaise. Or if you don't want to use mayonnaise, leave it off. But this is basically kind of a special grilled ham and cheese because we're going to use some Texas-size bread. It's Texas toast bread. In fact, you can buy it like this in a container that says Texas style toast. Now I am going to toast these on the stove, and I've gotten out four, so this will eventually stack with the ham and cheese and herb mayonnaise in between, and it will be a big sandwich. So you better have a hearty appetite for this, and it is full of fat, I'll have to say. So if you're watching your calories, this is probably not the sandwich that you want to make. I have other sandwiches that are much healthier, but sometimes you just want a treat, and I occasionally will give you a treat like this that I just say, well, let's just forget about it, or just eat half a sandwich maybe. Here's the way we start. I have some softened butter. My fork is here to test, and actually I used the microwave to soften that because I forgot about it earlier. Otherwise, I would have had it sitting out and getting to room temperature. But I'm just going to scrape some of that onto a spreading knife. And then what I want to do is to spread one side of, I'm making two sandwiches right now, so I'll spread one side of the four halves. So let me get that done and then I'll show you where we go from there. So I've spread up my four halves on one side, and honestly I do not put a lot of butter on here at all. It might be one teaspoon, but I make sure it's very thin. But I try to cover all the way. I try to get full coverage because what we're going to do now is turn each of these over so it's buttered side down, and then we'll take it to the stove top, and we'll grill these. And then we'll continue on with our sandwich. Now I've let these pieces of bread grill just a little bit on the stove, and I've been looking under them, and when they turn nice and toasty like that, then they're ready to come over to my workspace and we'll make sandwiches of them. We're not through grilling yet though. I'm going to turn each one over, and you'll need a utensil to do this because they're hot at this point. The purpose of that little bit of grilling right there is to give a good base for the mayonnaise that I'm going to put on. And as I mentioned, this is herb mayonnaise. Now my herb mayonnaise contains parsley, it has chives, it has oregano, it has basil, and it has dill. So it's going to be a nice blend of flavors. So you can put just a little bit, now that's a lot, but I'm going to separate this out. A little bit on each half. So I'll take half of that and transfer it over here, and half of this will transfer over to here. And then we'll spread it until it's thin. Doesn't that look nice? It's going to have a lovely flavor that you'll be surprised to get, because normally you're just expecting either a sandwich spread or mayonnaise, and this is a little fancier than that. It has a really rich taste. Very good. Now, after you have it spread, what you want to do is to add your ham and cheese. What I did was to go to my local grocery store in the deli department, and I asked for honey ham, and this was I wanted it sliced at about this thickness, and you can see it's a little over a quarter of an inch. So you choose whatever thickness you want, and I looked at the bread and I thought it's not any wider than that, so I kind of took a knife and took these slivers off, and I cut it across the center because we certainly can't fit a whole piece on there. But taking a half, you're going to put your ham on one of these and another one of these. Then you go to your cheese. What I have here is some cheddar cheese that I got from my deli and had it thick sliced. So that's about a quarter of an inch thick. Put that on top of the ham. And then we're going to put these together. So this goes on top with the mayonnaise side down. And what we're going to do is go back to our softened butter. And these are hot now. So as we spread it, it's going to spread probably pretty easily. but this will provide the base for our grilling technique that we already use. So you want to butter this very nicely, but not too much butter, because you want to take account of how much fat is going into these, and you don't want to just slop it on. Some people probably do that, and if you get it at a diner, it might come like that, and it might taste really good, but I try to watch the fat as much as I can. So what I'd like to do now is to flip this over, and I can butter the other side at my leisure, but the side that's going down is going to the stove. So I'll be buttering this and flipping it over and getting both sides grilled, and you'll see that in just a minute. I have turned these grilled ham and cheese sandwiches a couple of times, and you just kind of hold on to the top. They're not very hot. And you can turn them like that. And I can see that they're really done. Of course, they were done when they were put on here, but the idea is to get this nice and crusty, and also you want the cheese to melt. And I was at a place where I could see the cheese, and I could see it oozing out right there. When it's like that, you can go ahead and take it up. So I'm going to turn this off, bring it over here, and then I'm going to take one of these and put it on my plate, which I have a dill pickle spear on there, and with that I'm going to add my utensil for a minute, and then I'm going to make a diagonal cut, just go straight down, but kind of at an angle so that it looks a little fancy. And then when you open it up, you're going to see all the nice filling, which will have some cheese and ham and some herb mayonnaise. And the cheese should be nice and soft and melty, and the crunchiness of the loaf of bread is going to be really great. And the fact that it was very tall at the top is not too important now, because you can easily eat that. It's a little big over here, but you'll get to that eventually, and it's not a problem. So let me place this the way it should go. And if you want to, you can separate these and put the dill spear in the center. And this is our nice grilled ham and cheese sandwich with herb mayonnaise.